What's up? Welcome back to another video about MS in US. This is Swati and today I'll be sharing with you all my F1 student visa experience, the question asked in my interview and the overall process. Along with that, I'll be talking about some tips and tricks on how you can crack your visa interview. So let's start. So my USC visa experience was pretty amazing. I think I was very lucky on that day and I was fortunate enough that my interview lasted only for like 1.5 minutes and it got ended in less than 2 minutes. So I wasn't asked too many difficult questions and I wasn't grilled. I asked very specific and straightforward questions that I already prepared in advance. So I'm gonna share with you all those questions as well at the end of this video. So here goes my experience. So I appeared for my US interview in Delhi, US embassy located in Janakpuri. Interview was at 10:15 a.m. and it's usually mentioned in the appointment details that you need to be at US embassy consulate at least before 30 minutes. So I was there by 9:30, 9:45, and the first step was to get my I-20 and passport checked. So outside the US embassy, there was a long queue and there was a designated person who was making sure that everybody has their passport, I-20, and he was also giving a chit which had a number. Maybe that was a interview turn number. So we got that number and a chit and I got into the building. As soon as I entered US embassy, I noticed like there are multiple queues where people are waiting for their turn to be interviewed, and on the other hand there are like multiple visa officers sitting behind the window and conducting the interviews. So I was in one of the queues and there was a guy ahead of me. He went for his interview. So gladly or unfortunately, the distance between the visa officer window and the queue where I was standing was not that big, so I was able to hear a little bit of conversation. I'm saying unfortunately because the guy who went ahead, his visa got rejected, and that decreased my confidence a little bit. And next was my turn, so I got a little nervous, but I pretended to be confident. So unfortunately I didn't go to the same window. I was supposed to go to the same window, but there is somebody over there who manages like who goes to which window, and she asked me to go to another window. So I went to window 4. I remember the number also, and that guy was so sweet. He was so amazing. He didn't ask me many questions. As I said, my interview lasted for less than 2 minutes. So the only question that he asked me was, first he asked me for my passport and I-20, and I gave him my passport and I-20, and then he asked me like, why did you choose this university? And I already had prepared answer for this question. So like, these are the courses I want, and this university has the courses that I want to do, and the location is pretty good. So I gave him an answer in 2-3 lines. The question he asked me was, who is sponsoring for your education? And I replied him saying that my father is sponsoring my education. You can like mention anybody, like bank loan or your father or your parents or any of your relatives, whoever is sponsoring your education. And the final question he asked me was, do you have any relatives in US? To which I replied that I don't have any relatives, because I didn't. If you have relatives, don't hide it. Like, you need to be very honest while appearing for the US visa interview, and that is a key to get the visa. That was my US visa interview experience. I wasn't asked too many questions. I wasn't asked to show any documents, nothing at all. He just asked me a couple of questions and he gave me the visa. The reason he didn't ask me to show any documents or anything, because I think I was very confident and I was maintaining the eye contact throughout. Maybe I wasn't very confident from inside, but I was pretending to be confident and smiling, maintaining eye contact throughout. And that is the reason he didn't ask me too many questions and he didn't ask me for any documents at all. So the biggest takeaway here is, whenever you appear for an interview, be it student visa or tourist visa or any other kind of visas, you need to be very, very confident. So how can you be confident? The only way you can be confident is when you are prepared for the interview. So you need to be prepared for the interview. By preparing, I don't mean that you need to mug up all your answers, but you should know your answers. You should know what you're gonna respond when asked a questions. So the second thing you need to take care of is your documents. Make sure you have all the documents. Doesn't matter if they're gonna ask you for the documents or not. you should have the documents because it will help you in gaining the confidence. And when you're confident, you will end up getting the visa. So make sure you have all the documents. Third, and one of the most important factor is your interview attire. So what you wear on your interview day is really, really important because I truly believe that what you wear reflects on your personality. And visa officer, when he sees you, the first thing that he sees is what you're wearing and how you're looking. So you need to make sure that you're wearing formal clothes. Although US Embassy doesn't have like any dress code or anything, but you still need to look presentable. Your clothes should be ironed properly, cleaned, and they need to be formal clothes. Even personally, when you dress up, you tend to be more confident, and so make sure you wear formal clothes and not informal clothes. For men, it can be like shirts or pants or blazer, and for women, anything elegant with some sensible choices. It is maintaining a positive attitude. Make sure to keep smiling throughout the interview. Do not laugh, but just keep smiling and maintain a positive attitude. Keep answering the questions that visa officer asks. Be accurate and specific in answering the questions. Do not just recite the paragraphs that you mugged up. Do not mug it up. Just try to understand the situation and answer it correctly. And I'm sure you will get your student visa for sure. That's all for today's video. I hope you find this video useful. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel. I'll see you guys in my next vlog. Thank you.